Hi friends, my name is Mohit Mangal. I am a career counselor, and in this video today I will talk to you about career options in National Investigation Agency. How to become an NIA officer? Well, I will talk to you about NIA. What is it? Role of NIA, divisions which are there in NIA, qualities required in a candidate to join NIA. Then I will talk to you about the senior ranks entry options, junior ranks their entry options, and at the last I will talk to you details about the test or the selection procedure. Starting with NIA, popularly known as the National Investigation Agency, is a central agency established by Indian government to combat terror in India. It acts as a central counter-terrorism law enforcement agency. It is empowered to deal with terror-related crimes across states without special permission from the states. The agency came into existence with the enactment of the National Investigation Agency Act 2008 after the deadly 26/11 terror attack in Mumbai. It falls under the Ministry of Home Affairs. NIA has concurrent jurisdiction which empowers NIA to deal with cases related to terror attacks challenging the country's sovereignty and integrity, bomb blasts, hijacking of aircrafts or ships, attack on nuclear installations, smuggling in high quantity and quality counterfeit Indian currency leading to damaging the monetary stability of the country, human trafficking, manufacturing and sale of prohibited arms, and cyber terrorism. The qualities which are required by an officer of NIA would be: he or she should be practical and people oriented, good with interpersonal skills but not very outgoing, ready to work in high pressure, ready to handle crisis situations, disciplined and adventurous, ready to follow directions, and needs to be physically fit. The senior ranks which are there in the National Investigation Agency include Director General, Special Director, Additional Director, Inspector General, Deputy Inspector General, Superintendent of Police, Additional Superintendent of Police, and Deputy Superintendent of Police. The entry options at the senior ranks in the National Investigation Agency remain: the head of the National Investigation Agency is a director who is an officer of the Indian Police Services who is approved for appointment as the Director General of Police under the central government. The post of Additional Director General is deputed to an officer of the IPS who have been approved for appointment as an Additional General Director General of Police under the central government. Other ranks of the senior cadre, which are IG, DIG, SP, ASP, DYSP, are staffed by either the IRS officers or the IPS officers holding an analogous post. The question of this video for the viewer is: which entrance exam is required for becoming an IFS officer? Please put your comment in the comment section below after thinking, and I'll be happy to share my latest career guide worth ₹250 free of cost with you. Moving to the junior ranks of the NIA. The junior ranks include Inspector, Sub-Inspector, Assistant Sub-Inspector, Head Constable and Constable of National Investigation Agency. Looking at the inspector level, 45% of the officers are taken on deputation from the central government, state government or the union territories. 55% are direct promotion from sub-inspector. At sub-inspector level, 50% selection is done directly through the Staff Selection Commission Common Graduate Level Exam. 40% is through direct promotion, failing which they could be taken from deputation, and 10% are taken on deputation. At the ASI level, 50% are taken from the Central Armed Police Forces or State Police Forces or Government Intelligence and other investigation bodies. 25% are those people who have finished 3 years of regular service as a head constable, and after that they have to appear for the limited departmental competitive exam. And remaining 25% are direct promotion, which is after 5 years of regular service as a head constable. Then I move to the head constable. 50% of the positions here are filled on deputation from the Central Armed Police Forces or government intelligence agencies or other investigation bodies. 25% is through promotion, again with either 3 years of regular service as a constable, along with that one has to appear for the limited departmental competitive exam, and remaining 25% directly through promotion after 5 years of regular service as a constable. At the constable level, 80% of the posts are filled through the direct recruitment done by the Staff Selection Commission under the general duty exam, which can be 80% is through direct SSC, and remaining 20% are through the LDCE exam, that the limited departmental competitive exam for the lower divisional clerk. And in the constable general duty, if 80% seats are not filled, then they are taken on deputation from the Central Armed Police Forces or the State Police Forces. Now, moving to the Central Staff Selection Commission Common Graduate Level Exam, it is a four-tier exam. Tier 1 is a 60-minute duration, 4 subjects: General Intelligence and Reasoning, General Awareness, Quantitative Aptitude, and English Comprehension. Each has 25 questions, corresponding to each will be awarded 50 marks. Now, there are 2 marks given for the right answer and 0.5 is deducted for the incorrect answer. Then is the Tier 2 exam, which is 120 minutes computer-based exam, which again has 4 sections: Quantitative Ability, General Intelligence and Reasoning, English Language and Comprehension, Statistics, and General Studies including Finance and Economics. Here each section is 100 questions, 200 marks. Then is the Tier 3 and the Tier 4. Tier 3 is a descriptive paper, which is English or Hindi, where one has to write an essay or a pressy or a letter or application, which is 100 marks. And Tier 4 would be a computer proficiency test of 100 marks. The details of the vacancies and further syllabus and all you can get from the official website of Staff Selection Commission, that is ssc.nic.in. Then I talk about the details of the LDCE, Limited Departmental Competitive Exam. Now, for the position of ASI, Head Constable and Constable, there are the common LDCE is having 2 papers. Paper 1 is General Knowledge, along with it English language including comprehension and written ability, and paper 2 is a law paper. Both are 3 hours, both have 200 marks each. This is followed by evaluation of the service records. You can get to have the details of the same from the nia.gov.in exam. Further, there are certain special recruitments which may include technical forensic psychologist, biology expert, explosive expert, deputy legal advisor, senior public prosecutor, public prosecutor, senior system analyst, accountant, photographer, fingerprint expert, network administrator, programmer, assistant programmer. These are done either directly on short-term contract basis or through the they can take people through deputation from other investigating agencies. And the official website, as I already shared with you, for the National Investigating Agency is nia.gov.in. I hope this video could give you enough clarity related to National Investigating Agency, how to join, what are the positions available, and so on. If you seek career counseling, you can connect with my office at 7600-111. You can follow me on Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, or YouTube. My ID is IQUEMOHIT. My website is mohitmangal.com. You must subscribe to this YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. If you post a question or a comment in the section below, I'll be very happy to share my latest exclusive career guide worth 250 rupees free of cost with you. Thank you so much. God bless you.